In the last one, we looked at how to list out the database content of our application and render them on the browser. In this one, we will look at how to input those data in the database. So if you are not yet a subscriber, please subscribe to our channel so that you will not miss videos like this. So currently our application doesn't have an entry form. So now if I open the application, let's run the server first. I'm gonna cd into the directory, activate the environment. Okay, and then run the server. All right, once the server is running, we can now open the application. Okay, so this was our homepage. All right, so let's look at the URL pattern of our application. If I go to the projects and open urls.py, so this is our URL pattern. To see the list of items, I'm gonna do / list items. Let's call items. So this is what we did the last video. We were able to list out all the items from the database and then render them on this browser. So in this one, we want to look at how to input these details in the application. Currently, if I want to input data, I'll have to do / admin and then login. Okay, so now if I want to input data, I'll go to stocks and then I'll see the list of stocks that we have. Then I can do add stock. So once we fill this form and click save, it will be added to our stock list. Okay, and we can see all of them right here. So in this one, we want to be able to go to a URL like add items or add item, and the application should be able to give us a form where we can add these items through the front end of the application. Okay, so we have an error, page not found. So that means the URL that we are trying to reach is not available on our app. Okay, our app doesn't know about it. So these are the only three URLs that it know about: the home URL, the list items, and also the admin. From the blog, the first step is to create a view. So I'm gonna copy this view and then explain what's going on. And this will be pasted in views.py, all right? So I'm gonna open views.py, and below the list item view, I'm gonna paste it right here. So now if you look at the add items, we have this form, stock create forms, okay? So make sure it's imported from from.forms. Import stock create form. So on this view, we will have a form, and the form is the same form that we created in customized admin video, right? So I'm going to use this form, and this form, to remind you, the form is at forms.py, was created right here, and it is having these fields: category, item name, and the quantity. Okay, so now from the views, if I fill this form, before we save the form, we want to check that it has passed the validation. Okay, so later when I go to forms.py, we will add some validations right here. So we want to check whether it passes that validation. So once the data is validated, it will now do form.save. That means the data that we add in the form will be saved in the database. Okay, so the context is just the same as what we have in the list items. So we'll have the title as add items, and then we will have the form that is assigned up here. So we have two template tags. So in the template, we can use the form and title as the template tags to render these variables in the browser. Okay, if you look at the list item view and the add item view, we have slight differences in the title. So with this, the title, we assign it as a variable up right here. Okay, and the variable has this string. Okay, and in the context, we are calling this variable right here. Okay, so with this one, we are defining the string right in the context. So these are the same things, but accomplished in slightly different ways. Okay, so now we're gonna render the request, the template that we'll create shortly, and also the context, that is the one that we have in this context variable up here. Okay, so we're gonna return render the request, the add items.html, and also the context that we have right here. Okay, we'll create this add items template, but before that we're gonna go and create the URL first. So in url.py, so I'm gonna create another URL which we'll call the add items view instead of the list item view. Okay, so I'm gonna copy this, copy and paste it, and change it to add items. Okay, and the view will be add items, and I'm gonna name it add items. Okay, so if you look at the block, that is step two right here. Okay, so the third step and the final step is to create the HTML document. I'm gonna copy this, and then in templates folder I'm gonna right click and then click new file and save it as add items .html. So I'm gonna paste the content I copy right here. We are just creating a simple HTML page with a title, and that title is what we define in the context. Next, in the body is where we're gonna create our form. So we have this form. So within the form we have another template tag, and the template tag is what is gonna render the form, and the form is what we have right above the title. Okay, in the context we're gonna add an input button, and we're gonna give it a value of save with a type of submit. Okay, so notice that the form is having a method of post, so this will create a submit action on the browser. Okay, so when it is submitting it, the Django backend will receive that data and process it accordingly. Okay, and this is the process. Once we click on submit, it will check whether the form is validated, and then it will do the form.save. It will now try to save all the data that we have in the forms fields. Okay, but before we proceed, there is this CRF token right here. So with Django, out of the box takes security seriously, so this will take care of a lot of security related to submitting form on web browsers. All right, and this is required in the form for Django to be able to push your data in the database. All right, so once we have all that, we can save and then save the URL, and from here we can do add items again. I'm gonna add some S right here. I'm gonna add an S right here because that's the URL that we have. I'm gonna do enter. We have a form rendered on the browser. So I'm gonna fill out this form. The category is IT equipment. Okay, item name can be hard disk drive. Okay, and the quantity, I'm gonna give it 10. I'm gonna click save. Our application is not coded to tell us that this is saved, so we're gonna look at that in another video. When I click save, we can see quickly the browser kind of refreshed. Okay, and that is telling us that it is doing some action. So what happened was it sent that data in the database, and Django handled it in the back end. So we want to check that this item is properly saved on the database. So I'm gonna do a list item again. All right, indeed we can see that the data is saved in the database. So I did it twice, that's why we have it repeated right here. So in the future videos we'll see how to prevent that, and also how to redirect you to this page. Okay, so this is what we have in this video. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments below. Otherwise, see you in the next one.